County main office, and tickets may also be purchased from any Unicoi County Bluegrass Band student. And we have someone here tonight who has tickets. Raise your hand. All right, so if you're interested in going to that, see this young fellow right here. There's also a telephone number that you can call, area code 423-388-9473. We always like to open our Opry with a word of prayer, so if you'll bow your heads, we'll do that at this time. Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for this day that you've given us, that we can come out and enjoy each other's company and listen to some good music. We thank you, Father, for the care and the guidance that you give us in our lives. We thank you, Father, for this season that we've just gone through, celebrating the birth of Christ, our Savior. We thank you, Father, for caring for us and sending him for us. We ask, Father, that you would be with us now, forgive us of our many sins, and we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Our history moment for tonight. I don't know whether y'all were aware of it or not, but this is a book that the Boones Creek Historical Trust has put out. We ordered about 2,500 copies of it. We're down to, I think, about two boxes of it now, about 30 or so copies. We're going to do a second edition. But this book is a book that has 50 of the oldest homes in Boones Creek. They had to be 100 years old to get in the book. So that's what we've got here. Now, along with the homes, we have pictures of the homes in it. And we have recipes that the people who live in those homes have provided for us. I'm going to read you about one of the homes in our book. This is the Jesse Crouch Cabin. It's the oldest cabin that's standing in the Boones Creek area. Three brothers, Jesse, John, and Joseph Crouch, settled in the Boones Creek area in the summer of 1780. They came from Henry County and Stafford County in Virginia. Three cabins were built on a 300-acre farm, one being the Jesse Crouch Cabin. The cheeking in the cabin walls was filled with overlapping limestone rocks so the Indian arrows could not penetrate. The date 1790 is carved on an inside rafter, and 1796 was carved on one of the walnut porch columns. It is reported that Jesse was sent out to suppress some of the Indian activities during this time. The second occupant, Jackie Crouch, was stricken deaf and mute when he was 17 years old. He had an ear infection that he got from swimming in the river. Jackie was an accomplished trader and became wealthy through his trading. It is said of him that because he was deaf and talked very little, that he concentrated on being a good trader and didn't waste time talking. He went to Kingsport and built flat-bottom boats, then loaded the boats with goods that he had bought and floated them to New Orleans. Upon arrival, he sold his goods, then tore the flat-bottom boats apart and sold the wood that they were made out of. He traveled the Natchez Trace back home, From home, he would travel to Baltimore and Philadelphia, where he purchased goods with the money he had made from his New Orleans profits. Then he would travel back home with the goods and repeat the cycle again. The third occupant of this home was Reverend Thomas Hyder Crouch, who was instrumental in the founding of the Boones Creek Baptist Church in 1882. Currently, 32 Crouch family members own this log cabin and 10 acres that it's on. Warren Bowers Crouch serves as the overseer and lives next door to the cabin.
Not anymore.
And that's a picture of the cabin. That's your history moment for tonight.
That was 1700s?
1780s.
Well, Bill, you were around about that time, weren't you?
Hang around. We'll have you here for a while. Somebody whispered to me that you're about 92, 93 years old.
Give him a hand.
He'll be 94 the 14th of May. Now, his friend down here, I understand, is a little bit younger than he is.
I'm only 68, so I've got a long, long way to go.
Oh, somebody told me that you were 88.
Oh!
it ain't the years, it's the mileage.
It's the mileage, okay. Well, welcome, Bill and Tom. We're glad you're here.
Enough to have been back here in the 1780s, but he's old enough to have known the Carter family when they were still living down on Mesa Spring in Scott County, Virginia. We're Virginians, might as well tell them right off.
I know. Virginia's the mother of the nation.
But I got relatives from Franklin. This was a state at one time, wasn't it?
Yes. For 4 years.
4 years.
Yeah. Bill, why don't you tell them how you come across the Carter family? Yeah.
Well, I got a job with Pepsi-Cola, and I had no idea that I lived in 20 miles of Mesa Springs all my life. And when I left Hilton's and went up towards Mendota and saw the old store up there, the A.P. Carter, which, you know, it made the hair stand up on the back of my head. Of course, I've always loved the Carter family music, and Jeanette and Gladys, Joe and all the family were all precious to me. And Miss Sarah, AP's wife, she was a sweetheart. She was a dear friend. And she gave me a lot of encouragement. She told me most of the Carter folks said, "You're the one that sings here that I can understand what they're saying. That makes me feel good, you know." But they were precious. They took me to Meridian, Mississippi to the Jimmy Rogers Festival years ago, and I enjoyed that. And of course, the state fee, I hauled him up down the valley.
You played out there?
Oh, I played there a lot. I was regular there for years. But you know, I shot my walk, and I know it. But I think I've got old gracefully. And you know, if we know the Lord Jesus Christ, we still have everything. He's everything. So, y'all need to have a good time tonight, because I'm pretty sure you ain't going to get your money back.
This used to be Bill's theme song back when he was playing at the Carter Ford.
But we don't really sing.
We did, but the folks weren't here then.
Yeah. Well, he was a big, tall fella, sort of a dreamer. He walked the railroad with his hands behind his back and never said a lot, but he was always Pleasant. That was his middle name. Pleasant Carter.
Was he the kind of guy you could count on to help out around the house or the do chores?
Well, if he wanted to. If he thought about it, I guess he would. Like most men, their mind's usually somewhere else. and that's all right a lot of times. But he was always doing something. And you know, he accumulated a lot of ground, a lot of land. He bought a sawmill and a steam engine back in Kansas City and had a new car, and he tied it back to that car and pulled it back to Macy Springs. Never saw the board, but you know. A lot of us have done stuff like it. He was always doing something, but he always went. And, you know, he'd give the children all a home. And a fella run a store with one of my customers, and he said, AP, come in there and say, hey, boys, said, fill me up with gas and oil and stuff like that. And said, put it on my credit. He said, I'm going to heard of a song over in North Carolina. I'm going over and get it. He didn't write a lot of songs, but he saved a lot of that. We wouldn't have had him had it not been for people like AP. But he said he never beat him out of a diamond painting. And he was well respected in Macy Springs, Scott County. And all the Carters I know are good people. Joe and Jeanette and Gladys are all special people.
Want to do a little Greenfields of Virginia if the Tennessee folks will let us? This is Carter family too. G. Tennessee.
I know it.
Maybe a girl I love in sunny Tennessee.
If you haven't been to Kansas City in a while, just hang on to your seat.
Lucy, I play cross harp, so I play it out of the D harp, but it's key of blues in A. Ready? Going to Kansas City.
Kansas City.
Thank you. corner. Take us to Kansas City.
Jimmy Rogers tune I heard was Pete's Picking Time in Georgia, and I was about 7 years old, I guess, and Mom had one of those crank controls and made the hair stand on the back of my head when I put it together. And there'd be stars in my poor mother's crown for listening to all that cattywall that she put up with when I was trying to yodel.
But he learned it, boy. Now she put up with it, and he learned it. Now you think, how many 93-year-olds could do what he's going to do in this song?
When it's been a big time in Georgia, I thank you.
right ahead. We'll just start.
I hope they don't get me, cause I've got a sweet way.
I'm flat out of decimal nations. I'm going to stay at home in Scott County with this one. Carter family, go watch and shame. Talks a little bit about growing cold hearted and all that, and after a long time of being the one stuck at home looking after the kids, well, Mr. AP was off on his latest project or chasing the latest song. I mean, Miss Sarah struck up a friendship with another fella. And you might tell them that she, when they were singing on it, finally she just plain had enough.
And he was AP's cousin.
AP's cousin, Corbeys. I don't know if you've all heard that name.
Was an awful good fella, too.
Yeah. But finally they were playing a show down in Del Rio, Texas. Now she wrote a song called I'm Thinking Tonight of My Blue Eyes. And what'd she say on that show?
Was she saying,
or if you're, or if he was listening.
This is what 50,000 watt semi-pirate radio station in Del Rio, Texas. Could hear it all over the country at night. And she comes up with blue eyes. You know, if you're listening and you still want me, come and get me. and then she sang his song, NG.
Here before she died, but she passed away before she got here, but mm-hmm. She still died in Kingsport. Mm-hmm. And was buried over in Lacey Springs.
And they asked you to sing at her funeral, did they not?
Yes, I did.
Okay. And what was the song you sang?
Well, we need a hymn. No, I didn't.
Somewhere more.
Too many hymns with yodeling, and when the finally the record company finally got him to record a lullaby, he thought he yodeled into that too. I don't know how effective that would be as a lullaby to go yodeling to the baby, but he wrote.
We have a little practice on.
Thank you.
not only looked like Christian, but she dressed like Christian. God has certainly blessed us here in America, in East Tennessee, in Shasta, Virginia. It's been good to us. I've never been hungry over a couple of hours at a time. My wife, and that's because I was too sorry to go to the table. So God has certainly blessed me with everything that I've ever needed. He's kept me out of a lot of things that I could have had in a lot of trouble. Of course, I had a father and a mother that was pretty strict, too. I was more afraid of them than I was of God. And you know, there's not anything wrong with that.
That's right. God might get you, might judge you eventually, but they was there to judge you a lot quicker.
They not only judged them, but they executed whatever they did. And they buried them either. They didn't care whether the law liked it or not. They booked the law, too. But they were in charge, and I loved my mother and father. I had a wonderful mother and father. And they taught us the right things. And what we love come down. Are we out of time? Or?
Oh, we could do a hymn or two.
No, you're good. Do a couple of
you've got lots of time.
Lots of time.
Lots of time.
Well, we don't want to be piggish. The musicians are a little bad about playing over on somebody else's time.
Bill may be 93, but he'll go for 3 hours without a break.
Yeah.
Dana Prayton, or
you should bring it. Oh, man.
didn't see there, but you kind of switched there.
As I traveled through the streets.